morning, CHS. I hope you're having a great morning.
Now, let's get into your morning announcements.
We have so much to bring to you today. First, we'd like to share with you a special segment highlighting Trans Day of Visibility, which happens March 31st. The idea for the segment came from CHS Junior Ryan Lindstedts, who will be helping us gain more insight into the experience of being a trans person, the significance of Trans Day of Visibility, and why this, like all vulnerable communities, deserve our attention.
My name is Rylan, and I'm a transgender student at the school. Today, I'm talking about Trans Day of Visibility. Trans Day of Visibility is a day to celebrate and honor trans people and raise awareness for the discrimination trans people face on a day-to-day basis. Trans people experience gender dysphoria. It's the feeling of emotional distress and extreme discomfort in your body. I can't look at myself in the mirror. Like, I can't use the men's bathroom because in public spaces, because there is a chance someone will beat me up. I can't listen to myself talk. I can't see my, like, I don't like to look at myself. It's very difficult, and it's more than just, hey guys, I'm a guy now, please respect that. It's way more than that. This day is important because it's to honor and celebrate the trans people who are still here with us. Trans Day of Remembrance was a day to remember the trans people who have lost their lives to being hate crimes, discrimination. That day remembers the trans people who have passed, and this day honors the trans people of today. Don't ask them, why did you decide to be trans, or why did you become trans? Because being trans is not a choice, and it is not something you just become. Being trans is so much more than just, you wake up and you're like, I'm a guy now, so, you know, treat me like a guy. Don't ask them if they've had the surgery, because not every trans person gets surgery or takes hormones. That doesn't make them any less trans. Everyone experiences it differently. So there's not one defined way. This is just my personal experience I'm sharing. So people can educate themselves by doing research, you know, what's the difference between sex and gender, you know, how can I support my friend or loved one who's a part of the LGBTQ plus community or is trans? There's a ton of websites and resources, and so that's it. Have a good day. Bye. Stars welcome him with open
arms. That was such an impressive and important segment for all of us to see. Thank you so much, Ryland.
Up next, we're continuing the topic of communication. Mr. Figueroa is going to talk to us about mental health and using the resources provided to us by CHS.
Hey CHS, Mr. Figueroa here. If you're feeling anxious, overwhelmed, or unmotivated, that is your body and your mind telling you, hey, listen to me, I need help. And while you may be able to recognize that things don't feel quite right, you may not know exactly what to do about it. As a teacher, I often wonder how my students are doing, and it's difficult for me to tell that through this virtual format. As a student at Clifton High School, you have a whole bunch of resources available to you to help you manage difficult circumstances at home and to help you manage your mental health. These include your teachers, of course, your guidance counselors, and the student assistance counselors, as well as the teen center. I can think of a couple of instances in this school year alone where students have either stayed behind after class or talked to me before class and let me know that they had a really big issue that was preventing them from being able to give their best at school. And I was glad to be able to get those students the help that they needed and to work with them as they tried to resolve the issues that were going on. But the adults in your life may not necessarily know that something is going on with you and that you need help unless you're able to communicate that to them. The solution to every problem begins with you, and it begins with you asking for help when you need it. stay after class, send an email to an adult, talk to your parents about what's going on in your mind, let somebody in, let somebody help you. We want you to succeed. We want you to grow, to learn, and to be happy. Let us know how we can help you, and we will do our best to do just that.
Thank you, Mr. Figueroa. That was very helpful.
Finally today, we all may not be going away for spring break, but we can dream, can't we?
We sure can. Max Rubin put together this fun segment asking students to tell us about their dream vacation destinations. Let's check it out.
Hey guys, my name's Anastasia, and my dream vacation would probably have to be Cabo because I love the tropics and I love the beach.
My dream vacation would be Bermuda for the beautiful sand and water, the fancy restaurants, and of course, I'll be playing a few rounds of golf.
Hey CHS, if I could go anywhere on a vacation, I'd go to Whistler, Canada with my family to go and ski.
My favorite dream vacation spot is to travel all of Europe with my best friends.
My dream vacation is to tour Europe with friends all summer.
My dream vacation would be to go to South Island, New Zealand.
My dream vacation is to tour Italy and Greece with friends and family, visit some nice beaches, and eat some good food.
Dream vacation is to see the Northern Lights in Norway.
My dream vacation would be Sweden because it's so random.
Our dream vacation spot would be Greece.
We would go to Santorini to sunbathe, and we would go with each other.
My dream vacation is Okinawa, Japan, and I would go with my family.
My dream vacation would have to be Paris. I want to see the Eiffel Tower, and I want to enjoy some crepes.
I have no idea where I would go for my dream vacation, but my brother might have an answer for you.
I want to go to Duck Lake and Pond in Petco to get pets, and I can go and match the box. A guinea pig, a hamster, a ferret, a bird, a parrot.
All right, we're gonna need a bigger house. All right.
That was fun. There were some great ideas there.
There really were. Can't wait to go away on vacation. That's our show for you. I'm Catherine.
And I'm Chris.
And have a
we can't wait till spring break Thursday. You're so golden.